All right, guys. This is Rob and Kimber. We're back for another. Hey, I'm out of the screen. I think you moved my computer. There you go. We're back for another music reaction. This we're doing the bold and or the old and the bold.
You're about to mess up.
I think I'm the bold one. No. I mean, I'm the old one. Something along those lines. Anyway, Kimber wanted to go first this time with her pick on a song. For me to go ahead and listen to?
Yeah,
go ahead.
So it's a musical. I couldn't find the performance, so this is what I got. This is what I got. We got
okay, drummers. So this is a modern musical. Is that what you're saying?
It's just a musical that I know.
That came out not too long ago? Deals with what subject matter?
High school stuff.
Okay, so if you relate to it, it came out not too long ago.
It's not.
All right, here we go.
You dress better. You are 93% more attractive. You've had more experience
more?
With the opposite sex. Which is to say you've had experience with the opposite sex. But human activity is a matter of
input
as well as output. What does that mean? The fault is in your peers.
Here we go, Dan.
So, I was going to stop and ask, and then I just saw that last little bit of that scene where he holds the pill.
Yep.
So, he's either a drug or a drug dealer.
No, he is the robot that, when Jeremy first got the pill, that is a technology pill. So, it goes through the mouth, up to the brain. This is a hologram robot that helps him be more popular or be more chill.
Okay.
And he's trying to get Jeremy to give his peers the same pill. So
he's
a
drug dealer.
No.
Yes.
Because it's not a drug. It's not a drug.
The pill is a drug.
It's not a drug, though. It has technology in the drug to help people. I guess it's a drug. I don't know. I'm not even gonna fight you on this. This is not what it's supposed to be.
Open it.
I don't know the combination.
Oh.
One. Ladies, strange. There's gotta be enough scripts in here for
the entire school?
Hey, what's wrong?
I make my business to know everyone's business. But does anyone ever mind online?
So sad. But you can help her.
It looks
like a Tic
Tac, so it's like.
Yes. Whatever. I don't feel
anything. Oh! You've
taken
Mountain Dew. Oh! Gotta drink Mountain Dew. It is very painful.
Yeah.
basically happening. Jeremy wants to be more popular, and
so he's being more popular by giving everybody drugs.
And it's making him like him. No, it's taking. He's taking this like the more dramatic because there's an error in the program of the pill that he took. Now he's thinking, oh, to make him more popular, everybody has to be under his thumb and everything, and he do whatever he wants, and it's not like that.
So. Yeah, drugs.
No, it's not like drugs. It's technology in a pill.
Okay, yeah, that was very ominous, very Pitiful Children. The way to get popular.
Well, technically he took the pill so he can be popular to get noticed by a girl that he likes.
Uh-huh.
So that's that direction.
Does that ever work?
He got the girl at the end of this musical.
Yeah.
But
they were both hooked on drugs.
No, let's just say at the end of the movie, there's a mute. They had like a performance and then fight scene. There's like fight scene. So you just gotta watch the musical, man. I love it.
Okay. All right. So now I've got to think of a. Oh, I know what I could do.
And you could have sat there and have a. So you're gonna play some Queen, aren't you?
No. But we are going to play some of this.
It looked dumb as we did a reaction to the movie.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
All right, here we go. Anything you want to say before you start the video?
Yeah. This is going to be another one that you want to watch the video. Bell's not part of the song.
Sounds like a lullaby.
So I'm glad you picked up on that, because at the beginning and the end of the song, it is lullabies. It really is. And there's background echo right now. We're actually filming in a coffee shop, and people are talking. We're in a room in a coffee shop, and there's people talking right on the other side of the door. But anyway, the beginning of the song, and this guitar lick goes throughout the whole song. The three mm-hmm. know, lick. And that goes throughout the whole song. And it really is, it's another Sandman thing, okay? They're talking about the dream.
Another dream song.
And this first verse, he talks about,
don't
hold on. But if you listen to the words, he talks about this type of dream that you're having.
Mm-hmm.
To you leaving the game of life.
Somebody died.
In your dream.
It is another chance. Wide awake, you face the day. Your dream is over. Or has it just begun?
So the name of the song is Silent Lucidity.
Mm-hmm.
So if you know anything about dreams and stuff, mm-hmm. a lucid dream is a dream that you have somewhat control over.
Oh, so it's like...
Now, when I said earlier, think about Sandman, like we were, you know, the Sandman bring your dreams to you and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I want you to think of the singer of the song as the Sandman. He's the one who is in control of the dreams. Okay.
Okay.
He's the one with silent lucidity. He's keeping quiet, but he's the lucid one.
There's a place I'd like to find. A doorway that I run through at night. Relax, child, you live.
Double neck guitar.
So
they would occasionally play double neck guitars because they were able to tune them to different octaves. So you have one that's set higher, then they want to get into a different range.
Mm, okay.
So they, instead of picking up another guitar in the middle of the song, they would do a double neck thing.
So okay.
It was an old 80s rock thing. I don't think there's too many bands that do it anymore.
Okay.
Now he's still playing that same lullaby, the three beat thing. It's just hidden right now, but it comes back. Hear that? Who's dream control? talking about the lucid dreams. Mm-hmm. So listen to how the singer changes how he's talking to the person now when in the last part of the song.
Mm-hmm. If you open your mind for me, you won't rely on my open eyes to see. The walls you built within come tumbling down.
What'd you think of that one?
I'm not gonna lie, I'm about to fall asleep.
Oh, wow. Sorry.
No, it's like the lullaby music. And it's like, I don't even know what time it is. It's just like, I'm about to go to sleep to this guitar because it's so good, man. I was like,
Did you hear what he left out, though, on the last song where he said, smiling next to you? Mm-hmm. Earlier in the song, first half, he said, smiling next to you in silent lucidity. He was the one standing there in control. Mm-hmm. This time he left it out because through about halfway through that last verse, mm-hmm. he was talking about if you open your mind, you can take control. You can be the guide, he said. And so that person got lucidity.
And then control of the dream.
Yep. Yeah, and so the Sandman was just, okay, I'm standing here, but you're in control. I kind of thought that was always a cool little song. Anyway, I guess that's going to bring it to the end for
that's gonna wrap this up.
This one. Alrighty. And if we do any more, we'll do more. If not, well then, peace.
Bye.
Later.